Four-Star Playhouse, Singer presents Merle Oberon in Sound Off, My Love.
Well, Doctor?
Sit down, Mrs. Andrews, please. Well, from your x-rays, the whole picture is pretty hopeful.
You mean that an operation would restore my hearing?
No. No, your hearing deficiency isn't caused by anything structural. We can't look for help in that direction.
But it's getting worse. People's voices fading in and out. I'm not sure what anybody says anymore.
I know. It's a terrible strain trying to listen. You don't have to strain anymore.
Oh, no. I won't wear that.
Why not? No different than putting on a pair of glasses, getting a tooth replaced.
But you don't understand, Doctor. That would be an admission of my being ill, and my husband has no patience with sick people.
When he sees how relaxed you are, once you're able to hear again, he'll be as happy as you are.
But he doesn't know I'm losing my hearing. Nobody knows.
All right. Nobody needs to know if you don't want them to. Let your hair grow. That'll hide it. Well, then wear your collars high. You know, that lacy thing. As a matter of fact, you'd look quite attractive in that sort of thing.
Oh, I didn't come here to be flattered.
I don't flatter people, Mrs. Andrews. I'm a doctor.
I'm sorry. I can hear perfectly well when I'm not nervous, when I'm relaxed. I don't need that monstrosity.
You're too vain to want to hear again. There's nothing I can do for you.
What's the matter?
Good morning, Mrs. Andrews. I hated to wake you. You were sleeping so well. But you did say you wanted to go shopping this morning with Mrs. Robinson. What's the matter, Mrs. Andrews? Headache again?
Yes, headache.
Well, you'll be all right once you get some food in you.
Is Mr. Andrews having breakfast?
He just went down, ma'am. Now, you come down just as soon as you're ready. I'll have everything nice and hot the way you like it. Hurry on down.
Worse today. Much worse. I've got to keep calm. Hear better when I'm calm. Hear quite well. Got to watch my nerves. Watch my temper. Funny. They look the same. They haven't changed a bit, and yet... I won't give in to it. It's all a matter of willpower. Concentration. Stay calm. That's all. Stay close to people. Watch their lips when they talk. Good morning, dear.
What are you doing up so early? This is the crack of dawn for you.
I have a terribly busy day today. I'm going shopping with Betty.
So early? That's right. This is Freedom Day.
No, tomorrow. She gets her divorce tomorrow. But she can't go to court in just any old rag, you know.
Celebrating a divorce. Isn't that a little macabre? What time will you be back?
Yes, it is going to be hot.
How do you feel, dear?
Oh, fine.
Sure. Incidentally, I won't be home for dinner tonight.
What?
I have to work late. I said I have to work tonight. I won't be home for dinner.
Well, you don't have to shout at me, Bill.
Is anything wrong, Martha? You don't seem to be able to concentrate anymore. Is something bothering you?
Does there have to be something bothering me just because I don't hang on to your every word? Oh, has the mail arrived yet?
I'll see.
No, I'll...
Isn't she going to eat anything?
No, I don't think so.
I'm worried about her, Mr. Andrews.
So am I. Terribly worried. Oh, I won't be home for dinner tonight.
Mm-hmm. Agnes! The devil are you doing here? I thought you were upstairs. Martha, are you all right?
I was standing right there, right by the post. What happened?
I was backing out of the garage. I hit the post.
I was standing right there, just a moment ago. If I hadn't moved,
well, you might have killed her.
Don't you think I know that?
But it wasn't his fault.
Well, then let's go downtown, do some free and fancy shopping, and forget about it.
You all right? I'm going to have to take your car today. I haven't got time to get that flat fixed.
We'll take you, Bill. We're going right by your office.
Well, Betty, I don't feel like going shopping today. Will you go without me?
All right. Want me to take you downtown?
Thanks. You take it easy. I'm sorry.
I'll see you later, won't I?
Later?
At Maria's.
Oh, Betty, I don't feel up to a party today.
Well, if you won't go, I won't go either. Hate parties anyway.
Hey, I've got a 9:30 appointment. Will you call the garage and have that flat fixed?
I'll call you later.
No use kidding yourself any longer. There's no doubt about it anymore. You're deaf. Not just hard of hearing, but deaf. Clock.
The watch.
Watch? But it's so loud.
Oh, turn the volume control down just a bit there. Quite easy to manage. Now, for the mechanical side of it, this big battery, the B battery, is good for 6 weeks or more, but not that little A battery. It's kind of temperamental. 2 or 3 days, and it'll go out on you. Now, when that happens, when all sound cuts out on you, don't get panicky. Just stop and put in another A battery. Like that. Here, I'll give you a couple of extras to carry in your purse as spares. You know, that's really quite a gadget.
Oh? In what way?
Oh, well, most people have to take their sound as it comes. But not you. You can control it. Tune out anything you don't want to listen to. If a bore gets onto your ear and you can't get rid of him, just run your volume down a little bit and you'll find it's quite an advantage.
You don't have to recite the sales talk, Doctor. I'm going to buy you a little toy.
Well, if you feel that way about it, Mrs. Andrews, you can take it off. If you're too proud to wear that, I know a lot of people who aren't. You realize there are kids who've never even heard the sound of an ice cream wagon coming down the street? And older people, too. Oh, a lot of them. Want to catch every bit of the finale any way they can.
I'm sorry.
Just don't be ashamed of it, that's all. Giving you back the precious gift of sound. Be grateful. Well, now why don't you go out into the wide world and find out what it sounds like, huh? Enjoy yourself a little. Celebrate.
As a matter of fact, I've been invited to a party.
Well, why don't you go?
Think I will. Thank you. For everything.
Welcome, beautiful stranger. Enter. I brewed this especially for you.
Thank you.
Glamorous one that just came in.
Don't you know our Johnny Belinda?
Who?
She's deaf as a post. Hello, darling. The pitiful part of the whole thing is that she thinks she's fooling everybody, and everybody knows she's deaf.
And dumb. Especially where her husband, shall we say, his extracurricular activities are concerned. Smoke, I forgot. Bill's in the kitchen with her now.
With whom? Oh, with Juan.
Oh, give that man $64.
Hello, darling. You look beautiful today.
Maria.
Martha, darling. Betty said you were sick. You do look sick. You're absolutely peaked. What you need is another drink.
Where's Bill, honey? Haven't seen him in ages. We miss him around here. Saved by the bell.
Did you get him out?
Out the back door.
He must be crazy cheating on her.
Well, when he married her, she was gay. She was fun. But now... Oh, well, she's terribly neurotic. But you can't expect a man like Bill. Well, after all, he is an attractive man.
Darling, you're not leaving. You just got here. You've got a lot of drinking to do to catch up with the rest of us.
Bill and Maria. Maria and Bill. How could I have been so blind? So deaf. Detained. Working late. Corny. Cliche, cliche, right down the line. The wife's the last to know. What do you say to your husband when you find out he's been cheating? You should have told me. I would have understood. Would I? Am I any different from any other woman?
All the way home. It's driving me crazy. Oh, of course nobody can hear me. She's asleep. Even if she weren't, what difference does it make? She can't hear. I know, darling. I know we can't go on like this. I can't. Everything I have has been transferred to her name. I can't divorce her. Darling, please. Be patient. I'll work it out. I'll get rid of her, I promise you. But it's got to look like an accident. I can't understand what went wrong this morning. She was standing right by that post when I backed out. The speed I was going at... Don't worry, darling. Next time, I won't miss.
Give me the police department. All right. I'll wait.
Martha. What are you doing out of bed? Are you sick? What were you doing on the phone? Who were you talking to?
I couldn't sleep. I didn't want to disturb you.
Who were you talking to?
The operator. I was asking her the time.
Why didn't you look at the clock?
It's not keeping time. It hasn't been for weeks.
Come on, Martha.
No, I've got a headache.
You should see a doctor about those headaches. Come on.
sorry, Mrs. Andrews. I didn't mean to startle you. Mr. Andrews has had his breakfast and gone. He didn't want to disturb you.
Thank you. I'll be down in a minute. Hello? Betty, please come over right away.
Martha, what's the matter?
I can't tell you on the telephone. Just come over.
But... Well, all right, if it's that urgent, I'll be there. Now, what sort of a jam are you in, anyway? Over the telephone, you sounded as if the hounds were at your heels.
Bill is going to kill me.
What?
Betty, you've got to help me. I haven't anyone else to turn to.
Honey, you're shaking all over. Come on, sit down. Now, tell me, what did you and Bill quarrel about?
We didn't. You don't believe me, do you? I wouldn't have believed it either if I hadn't heard him tell Maria on the telephone.
Maria?
Oh, you don't have to look so startled, Betty.
When did he call her?
Last night at 12:30. Everybody knows about it. They were all talking about it at the cocktail party yesterday. You must have known about it too, Betty. Why didn't you tell me?
It's not the easiest thing to tell your best friend.
I've got to get away from here before he comes home.
Honey, I can't follow all this. Bill kill you?
Betty, I tell you, he's already tried once. That was no accident at the mailbox yesterday. I heard him tell Maria. And I think what a fool I've been, kidding myself all the way around. Deluding myself that he loved me, when all the time...
When did you get it?
What?
The hearing aid.
Oh, yesterday.
Oh, darling, I'm so happy for you. If you knew how many times I've suffered for you, watching you struggle to hear with that awful pride of yours.
You knew, too?
That you couldn't hear? Yes, darling, I knew.
And I think what might have happened if I hadn't got it. I've got to get away from here. Hide.
Darling, don't go all to pieces. If this is true, you've got to think straight. Does Bill know you suspect?
No.
Well, then there's nothing to be afraid of. Look, here's the key to my cabin. Now, he'd never think to look for you there.
No, he wouldn't, would he?
I can't go with you. I have to appear in court this afternoon, but I'll come up tomorrow. Darling, you take it. Go on up there. No one will bother you. You're going to be all right.
Yes, I'll be all right.
Of course you will.
To close up.
I'm sorry to bother you, but am I on the right road for Hiram?
That's right. About a mile down the road, you'll come to the turnoff. It's marked. You can't miss it. Is Mrs. Robinson opening the place up this season?
Not exactly. Could I have some cigarettes, please?
Yes, ma'am. Wonderful spot, Hiram. Too bad she doesn't use it more often. Good hunting around here. I'm going to try and get a couple of hours shooting in before dark.
Oh, and perhaps I better have a quart of milk.
Yes, ma'am. Mrs. Robinson coming up?
Oh, and some cookies, please.
Oh, I'm afraid all I've got left is oatmeal cookies.
That'll be fine, thank you. Well, how much do I owe you?
Well, let's see. That'll be 64 cents. Sure this is all you'll need?
Quite sure.
$0.64 out of a dollar, that's 36 cents change.
Thank you.
Thank you. And watch for that turnoff. It'll take you straight on up to High Rim.
Wait! Wait!
Auntie.
Hello, darling. What's the matter? Surprised? Of course you were expecting Betty.
But how did you know? No one knew I was coming up here. No one except Betty.
That's right. No one except Betty.
Betty wouldn't tell you. Betty's one. That's what they said, a blonde. And they didn't mean Maria, did they? They meant Betty.
It's always been Betty. Betty and me.
Betty. My best friend.
Yes. I'm very fond of her, too. I don't know what gave you the idea it was Maria. But it doesn't matter now, does it, dear? Go ahead. Where can you go?
What are you going to do?
You've left me no alternative. You were going to run away. Keep my money. I couldn't afford that. I'd be broke. I'd have to start all over again, and how could I marry Betty? She doesn't have any money either.
But you can have it, Bill. You can have the money.
No. It's too late for that.
No!
Sound off, my love.
Mister, what are you trying to do?
Easy now. Careful. You'll be all right.
Where is he?
Are you all right? He was trying to kill you. Who is he? Oh, so that's it. I tried to catch you back at the store, but you didn't hear me. I tried to tell you that you'd left your wallet.
My wallet?
It's a lucky break for you that you didn't hear me. Well, I guess I'd better get to the sheriff and report this. Say, who was he anyway? Did you know him? Was he a stranger?
Stranger? Yes, he was a stranger. I guess I never did know him.
All the way home. It's driving me crazy. Oh, of course nobody can hear me. She's asleep. Even if she weren't, what difference does it make? She can't hear. I know, darling. I know we can't go on like this. I can't. Everything I have has been transferred to her name. I can't divorce her. Darling, please. Be patient. I'll work it out. I'll get rid of her, I promise you. But it's got to look like an accident. I can't understand what went wrong this morning. She was standing right by that post when I backed out. The speed I was going at... Don't worry, darling. Next time, I won't miss. Martha. What are you doing out of bed? Are you sick? What were you doing on the phone? Who were you talking to?
I couldn't sleep. I didn't want to disturb you.
Who were you talking to?
The operator. I was asking her the time.
Why didn't you look at the clock?
It's not keeping time. It hasn't been for weeks.
Come on, Martha.
No. No, I've got a headache.
What the devil are you doing here? I thought you were upstairs. Martha, are you all right?
I was standing right there, right by the post. What happened?
I was backing out of the garage. I hit the post.
I was standing right there, just a moment ago. If I hadn't moved,
well, you might have killed her.
Don't you think I know that?
But it wasn't his fault.
Well, then let's go downtown, do some free and fancy shopping, and forget about it.
You all right? I'm going to have to take your car today. I haven't got time to get that flat fixed.
We'll take you, Bill. We're going right by your office.
Well, Betty, I don't feel like going shopping today. Will you go without me?
All right. Want me to take you downtown?
Thanks. You take it easy. I'm sorry.
I'll see you later, won't I?
Later?
At Maria's.
Oh, Betty, I don't feel up to a party today.
Well, if you won't go, I won't go either. Hate parties anyway.
Hey, I've got a 9:30 appointment. Will you call the garage and have that flat fixed?
I'll call you later.
No use kidding yourself any longer. There's no doubt about it anymore. You're deaf. Not just hard of hearing, but deaf. Clock.
The watch.
Watch? But it's so loud.
Oh, turn the volume control down just a bit there. Quite easy to manage. Now, for the mechanical side of it, this big battery, the B battery, is good for 6 weeks or more, but not that little A battery. It's kind of temperamental. 2 or 3 days and it'll go out on you. Now, when that happens, when all sound cuts out on you, don't get panicky. Just stop and put in another A battery. Like that. Here, I'll give you a couple of extras to carry in your purse as spares. You know, that's really quite a gadget.
Oh? In what way?
Oh, well, most people have to take their sound as it comes. But not you. You can control it. Tune out anything you don't want to listen to. If a bore gets onto your ear and you can't get rid of him, just run your volume down a little bit and you'll find it's quite an advantage.
You don't have to recite the sales talk, Doctor. I'm going to buy you a little toy.
Well, if you feel that way about it, Mrs. Andrews, you can take it off.
I've got to get away from here. Hide.
Darling, don't go all to pieces. If this is true, you've got to think straight. Does Bill know you suspect?
No.
Well, then there's nothing to be afraid of. Look, here's the key to my cabin. Now, he'd never think to look for you there.
No, he wouldn't, would he?
I can't go with you. I have to appear in court this afternoon, but I'll come up tomorrow. Darling, you take it. Go on up there. No one will bother you. You're going to be all right.
Yes, I'll be all right.
Of course you will.
About to close up.
I'm sorry to bother you, but am I on the right road for Hiram?
That's right. About a mile down the road, you'll come to the turnoff. It's marked. You can't miss it. Is Mrs. Robinson opening the place up this season?
Not exactly. Could I have some cigarettes, please?
Yes, ma'am. Wonderful spot, Hiram. Too bad she doesn't use it more often. Good hunting around here. I'm going to try and get a couple of hours shooting in before dark.
Oh, and perhaps I better have a quart of milk.
Yes, ma'am. Mrs. Robinson coming up?
Oh, and some cookies, please.
Well, I'm afraid all I've got left is oatmeal cookies.
That'll be fine, thank you. Well, how much do I owe you?
Well, let's see. That'll be 64 cents. Sure this is all you'll need?
Quite sure.
$0.64 out of a dollar, that's 36 cents change.
Thank you.
Thank you. And watch for that turnoff. It'll take you straight on up to High Rim.
When he married her, she was gay. She was fun. But now, oh, well, she's terribly neurotic. But you can't expect a man like Bill. Well, after all, he is an attractive man.
Darling, you're not leaving. You just got here. You've got a lot of drinking to do to catch up with the rest of us.
So blind, so deaf, detained, working late. How corny. Cliche, cliche, right down the line. The wife's the last to know. What do you say to your husband when you find out he's been cheating? You should have told me. I would have understood. Would I? Am I any different from any other woman?
All the way home. It's driving me crazy. Oh, of course nobody can hear me. She's asleep. Even if she weren't, what difference does it make? She can't hear. I know, darling. I know we can't go on like this. I can't. Everything I have has been transferred to her name. I can't divorce her. Darling, please. Be patient. I'll work it out. I'll get rid of her, I promise you. But it's got to look like an accident. I can't understand what went wrong this morning. She was standing right by that post when I backed out. The speed I was going at... Don't worry, darling. Next time, I won't miss.
Thank you.
Get me the police department. All right. I'll wait.
Martha. What are you doing out of bed? Are you sick? What were you doing on the phone? Who were you talking to?
I couldn't sleep. I didn't want to disturb you.
Who were you talking to?
The operator. I was asking her the time.
Why didn't you look at the clock?
It's not keeping time. It hasn't been for weeks.
Come on, Martha.
No. No, I've got a headache.
You should see a doctor about those headaches.
Mrs. Andrews, I didn't mean to startle you. Mr. Andrews has had his breakfast and gone. He didn't want to disturb you.
Thank you. I'll be down in a minute. Hello? Betty, please come over right away.
Martha, what's the matter?
I can't tell you on the telephone. Just come over.
But... Well, all right, if it's that urgent, I'll be there. Now, what sort of a jam are you in, anyway? Over the telephone, you sounded as if the hounds were at your heels.
Bill is going to kill me.
What?
Betty, you've got to help me. I haven't anyone else to turn to.
Honey, you're shaking all over. Come on, sit down.
Now, tell me, what did you and Bill quarrel about?
We disturbed you.
Who were you talking to?
The operator. I was asking her the time.
Why didn't you look at the clock?
It's not keeping time. It hasn't been for weeks.
Come on, Martha.
No. No, I've got a headache.
You should see a doctor about those headaches.
Mrs. Andrews, I didn't mean to startle you. Mr. Andrews has had his breakfast and gone. He didn't want to disturb you.
Thank you. I'll be down in a minute.
Hello?
Betty, please come over right away.
Martha, what's the matter?
I can't tell you on the telephone. Just come over.
But... Well, all right, if it's that urgent, I'll be there.
Now, what sort of a jam are you in, anyway? Over the telephone, you sounded as if the hounds were at your heels.
Bill is going to kill me.
What?
Betty, you've got to help me. I haven't anyone else to turn to.
Honey, you're shaking all over. Come on, sit down.
Now, tell me, what did you and Bill quarrel about?
We didn't. You don't believe me, do you? I wouldn't have believed it either if I hadn't heard him tell Maria on the telephone.
Maria?
Oh, you don't have to look so startled, Betty.
When did he call her?
Last night at 12:30. Everybody knows about it. They were all talking about it at the cocktail party yesterday. You must have known about it too, Betty. Why didn't you tell me?
It's not the easiest thing to tell your best friend.
I've got to get away from here before he comes home.
Honey, I can't follow all this. Bill kill you?
Betty, I tell you, he's already tried once. That was no accident at the mailbox yesterday. I heard him tell Maria. And I think what a fool I've been, kidding myself all the way around. Deluding myself that he loved me, when all the time...
When did you get it?
What?
The hearing aid.
Oh, yesterday.
Oh, darling, I'm so happy for you. If you knew how many times I've suffered for you, watching you struggle to hear with that awful pride of yours.
You knew, too?
That you couldn't hear? Yes, darling, I know.
When I think what might have happened if I hadn't got it. I've got to get away from here. Hide.
Darling, don't go all to pieces. If this is true, you've got to think straight. Does Bill know you suspect?
No.
Well, then there's nothing to be afraid of.
Look, here's the key to my cabin. Now, he'd never think to look for you there.